walk into my parlor, said the spider to the fly. 'Tis the prettiest little parlor that ever you did spy. The way into my parlor is up a winding stair, and I have many curious little things to show you when you're there. Oh, no, no, said the fly, to ask me is in vain, for who goes up your winding stair can never come down again.
Are you okay, Mom?
It's just a little stomach ache. Can you keep an eye on the baby while I lay down?
Yeah. It's okay. Everything's gonna be okay. Good night, little brother.
Give me strength, lords. Hospital, sweetheart.
Why not?
It's time for the final step.
What are you talking about?
Thank you. 911, where is your emergency?
Daniel, it's the only way. For the good of us all. Just don't understand. Where is he, Daniel?
Hello? Anyone home?
I was wrong. There's one more.
Oh, my parents flipped when they found out I applied out of state, but whatever. It's not like they really have a say in what I do.
Man, you're so lucky. I'd give anything to get out of here.
What, Mary Mother of God still calling all the shots?
She thinks colleges are morally corrupt breeding grounds.
Well, yeah. Damn it. Nothing yet.
Birthday present.
Jealous.
Hey.
What?
Hey. Eventually, my mom's gonna start to notice.
Come on, she never notices.
She's gonna be home any minute, so you gotta clear out.
Why?
Because.
because you know I'm not supposed to have friends over, especially you.
Come on. Typical.
What? Have you ever had a thought that she didn't feed you?
Of course.
Yeah? Oh, let me see your cell phone real quick.
You know, I don't have one.
Right. Why is that again?
Because they cause brain tumors.
Bingo. See? It's like your weird little clone.
Goodbye, Scott.
I'm gonna come back and find you and her running a creepy motel right off the interstate, aren't I?
Get a TV.
This is Andrew Judson.
Hi, Mr. Judson. This is John Petrie.
Yes, I've been waiting for you, Colin.
Yeah, I think there's been some kind of mistake. I don't know any Benjamin Conroy.
That's no mistake. The estate of Mr. Conroy has been willed to you as of your 18th birthday, which was a few days ago, if I'm correct?
Yeah, but, again, I...
The property's worth a substantial amount of money. We really need to go over all the logistics in person. When's the soonest you can come to Wellfield?
See, that's the thing. I can't exactly just leave.
Yes,
Mr. Judson, I'll call you back. Hi, Mom. New doctor?
I ran into Helen Sampson today. She told me about this new medication her daughter was prescribed for generalized anxiety and mild depression. Dr. Webster said it was too dangerous to take with Klonopin and Valium. So I went to Helen's doctor, and he was more than happy to prescribe it.
It's great.
That's the last time I see that Webster quack.
Hey, Mom, can I talk to you about something?
If this is about going to college again, you can stop right there. Those communal showers are nothing but state-sanctioned homosexual bathhouses.
No, I was wondering if I could go,
To church? Don't think I don't know how long it's been since your last confession.
No, Mom, to this town. It's called Wellfield. It's in Maine.
Pardon me?
I got this letter today, and...
No, I'm not going anywhere, do you hear me? I am your mother, and I make the rules around here, so not another word.
But...
Not another word.
Who's Benjamin Conroy?
Are you Mary's son?
Yes.
I wanted to hold her for a few days for a more thorough psych evaluation, which, trust me, sounds much worse than it is.
A few days?
Yeah.
Mr. Judson?
Hey, man.
Hi.
You look a little lost.
No, I'm fine.
Sure about that?
I'm kind of looking for this lawyer's office.
Oh, Mr. John Petrie. He's just around the corner there.
Great, thank you.
If you want my advice, which you do, you'll turn around and get your sorry ass back on that train.
How would I do that?
Listen to him, okay? Nobody wants you here.
Everything's been fine here for 17 years. You had no right coming back and taking up the past.
Listen, I don't know what you're talking about.
Hey, don't let him go, Matt.
Just so we're clear, you don't belong in this town. Understand? See you around.
I'm glad you were able to come up here so quickly. The sooner we get the ball rolling, the sooner both of us can be on our way to the bank.
Uh-huh.
Your mother was okay with you coming up here?
Well, it's not like she really has any say in what I do. Mr. Judson, I've still got a few questions.
Ah, here we are.
Just look at it.
Okay. Yeah, the house over here, barn out back. Property stretches far into the woods over there, covering approximately 125 acres.
Mr. Judson,
I already have a developer lined up who's been waiting years to get a hold of the property, so I was able to negotiate a great price, pending your approval.
Wait, can you just hold on a second?
Yeah, what is it?
Who is Benjamin Conroy?
I'm sorry, I just thought you knew.
No.
You should really talk to your mother about this. Trust me, it's not my place.
Look, I tried, she wouldn't tell me.
More reason for me not to get involved.
Please, I'm just trying to figure out why I'm here.
Because you're next of kin to the Conroy family.
Next of kin? Is Benjamin like a cousin or something?
No, not a cousin.
What then?
Benjamin Conroy is your father.
See, I knew this had to be a mistake. My father's name was Ed Petrie. He died years ago.
Your mother was Benjamin's sister. She adopted you after your family passed away.
That's impossible. I'd remember something like
that. You were only a year old. I'm sorry you had to find out like this. Hey, get out of here. You okay? He didn't hurt you.
No, I'm fine.
Let's go see the house.
I had the power turned on for showing the buyers. I also had an antiques dealer put a quote together, assuming you want to sell the furniture, minus a small percentage for my finder's fee.
Is this my family?
Yes, I suppose so.
What happened to them? Mr. Judson?
Honestly, I really don't know that much about it. Some kind of accident. I have a 4 o'clock, so we need to get going.
Already?
Yeah. So the property was originally made in 1816. Back then, it sat on 400 acres. It was originally farm country.
So, I booked you a room at the hotel by my office so we can meet tomorrow morning and go over all the paperwork.
Actually, I was kind of thinking that I might like to stay here for a little longer. Is that okay?
I mean, it is your house, but I wouldn't suggest poking around in there.
Why not?
It's just, it's not sanitary.
I'd like to stay. I mean, I'm staying.
Fine. Okay, here's my card. The number for a cab service. Give him a call when you're done. Assuming you haven't caught some sort of hepatitis by then. Enjoy.
Thank you.
I guess. Oh, and Johnny. Happy birthday.
Hello?
Hi, Johnny. It's Andrew Judson. I just called to let you know I had the line turned back on.
Oh, okay. Thanks, Mr. Judson.
Is everything all right?
Yeah, everything's fine.
Okay. Give me a call if you need anything.
All right, I will.
I'll see you tomorrow.
Sounds good. Thank you. Hello?
Colin Conroy.
Who's up there? Hello?
Can I help you?
I'm sorry I scared you. I didn't think anyone would be coming back, so I kind of panicked.
Okay.
Though technically, I think you're the one who barged in on me, so I don't think I should be the one apologizing.
No, I didn't barge in.
You didn't exactly knock either, did you?
No, I didn't knock.
Well, now that we've established that, I'll be upstairs.
Hey! Who are you?
See, I should be asking you the same question.
Yeah, but this is my house.
And? Not looking for a roommate?
Not exactly. I'm supposed to be selling it tomorrow.
If I wasn't mistaken, that would be your way of telling me I had to leave.
Kind of. Sorry.
No worries. Whatever.
Wait, slow down.
No, thanks.
Do you have a name?
I'm not a stray cat. Of course I have a name.
Well, what is it?
Emma.
Emma? I'm Johnny.
Sure you are.
Has he been living here?
You can say that.
Why?
It's been abandoned for years. I didn't think anyone would mind.
What, did you run away or something?
Something.
Do you have anywhere to go?
All right, enough.
What?
With the questions, okay?
I'm sorry, I didn't expect anybody to be here.
Well, I'm leaving, so you can go ahead and pretend like it never happened.
Emma.
What?
Would you mind showing me around the place before you take off?
I think you can handle it yourself.
Please? I'd really appreciate it.
I suppose. Guess we'll start with the basement. I saw some bulbs down there a while back.
So how long have you been here?
I don't know, a day or two. Watch your step. But I didn't think I'd witness the return of the prodigal son, though.
What are you talking about?
You're the long-lost Conroy, right?
Wait, you know who I am?
The whole town knows who you are. Or at least they think they do.
Why do they know about me?
Again, with the questions.
Hey, Johnny.
Sorry.
Relax.
I was probably gonna be here for a few more hours if you wanted to stick around.
I don't know.
To be honest, I could use the company. I don't really know anybody around here.
Guess I don't have anything else to do.
Don't tell me there's somebody else staying here too.
No.
Anybody up here?
The upstairs is empty.
Looks like the door blew open.
Oh.
Johnny, do you believe in ghosts? You should see your face right now.
Emma!
Hey. You can smoke in the house if you want to. I don't care.
Shut up, I don't smoke. Give me a push.
Have you been in the barn?
Gross. No. Just looking at it gives me tetanus. So what are you gonna do when you sell this place?
Probably head back to the city, finish school. Maybe use the money to go to college.
You're from New York?
Yeah, born and raised. Oh, raised.
Don't you love it?
You know, I honestly never got out much besides, you know, school and church.
Jesus, why the hell do you want to go back?
I don't know. I guess I always thought I'd eventually have to.
If I were you, I'd just pick up and start over. New town, new place, new name, new everything.
Is that what you did?
Come on.
Where?
You said you wanted to see the barn, right? Locked from the inside.
I think I can get in from the top. You coming?
Absolutely not. Johnny?
Yeah.
see this.
Johnny?
Coming. Bro.
I don't know. There was someone behind me.
Who?
Anything upstairs?
No, just jumped.
Probably go inside.
Yeah.
Don't step another foot in this room, you pervert!
You've reached the Petries. Please leave your name and a brief message and have a blessed day.
Johnny, this is your mother again. I don't know what kind of joke you're playing, but I expect you're here first thing in the morning to get me out of this place.
So, do you know anything about my family?
That depends. What do you already know?
That there was an accident?
I wouldn't exactly say that.
Well, what happened then?
How should I know? It's your family, not mine.
I don't know. I just felt connected to this place from the second I got here.
There is this strong, tragic energy, right? Just looking at the photos, you can tell. At one point, the Conroys were happy.
Listen, it's getting pretty late.
I get it. Time to go.
No, wait. I was gonna say, I'm spending the night, so if you wanted to stay another day.
Thanks.
I thought, what's wrong?
You know how I said I thought I saw someone outside earlier? I think they're back.
Did you hear that?
Shh.
Go ahead, Mac. Let him know whose house this is.
Why don't you come out, Mr. John Petrie?
We ain't gonna hurt you.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
Wait, what are you gonna do?
I'm calling the cops.
Oh! Open up, buddy! We just wanna hang out!
There are people trying to break into my house. Now, I'm not sure of the address exactly. It's the Conroy farm.
There's things you need to know. So let us in this house.
I just need you guys to send somebody right away, please.
What are you looking at?
Mac.
It's for the good of us all.
What? Thank you. Okay, they should be here soon. Emma? Where'd you go?
Oh. Mac, we gotta bail.
What? Why?
There's someone out back.
Yo, Mac, let's go. Come on.
Emma, is that you?
Shouldn't have come back here.
You let them out! You know that? You let them out!
All right, Henry, let's go. Come on. It's getting late. No, no. Watch your step. There you go. Nice and easy now, okay?
We're just gonna take him down the station, throw him in the drunk tank for the night.
Who is he?
Henry Deptford. He used to be a sheriff up here. Honestly, he's a pretty harmless guy.
I don't want to tell him that.
I think he was just trying to scare you is all. Well, Henry became pretty obsessed with this place after he discovered the bodies in the barn.
He found the bodies?
Yeah, Brian. He's the one who found you hidden in the basement that night.
Sorry, what did you call me?
Your name's Brian, right?
Yeah, right. I'm sorry. I'm just, I'm a little on edge.
I can understand that. You staying up here by yourself?
Yeah, just for tonight.
All right. Well, you want to press charges, you come down to the station tomorrow.
No, it's okay. Can you just make sure that he doesn't come back?
I'll have a talk with him.
Thank you.
All right? Be careful up here, all right?
Eventful evening.
Hey, why'd you disappear?
Wow, what? I've been here the whole time.
No, you haven't.
You're right. Fine, I lied.
Yeah, you do that a lot, don't you?
I like you, Johnny. But you'll never know me. That doesn't mean we can't be friends.
Johnny?
Hi, Mom.
Where the hell have you been? I've been trying to get a hold of you all day.
I'm home, Mom.
Well, get back here immediately and bring me my prescriptions.
mean I'm at my home.
In Wellfield.
I can't believe you deliberately disobeyed me like this. You better get back here, Johnny.
No, I can't believe you didn't tell me.
How could you hide the truth from me about my family?
Mom?
You don't understand, Johnny. Benjamin was an awful man. I couldn't let you grow up like that.
So you lied to me instead?
I didn't lie to you. I just...
Just left out the truth?
Just come back here and we'll discuss this.
I don't know if I'm coming back.
Johnny, please don't do this.
Sorry, did I say you could come in? Johnny. That feels good.
Sorry, Ryan. What's wrong?
You saw something out there, didn't you?
Yeah.
I didn't hear so much as a creak before you got here. You woke something up.
family. I think they need my help.
Something touched me in the other room, and it definitely wasn't asking for help.
Look, I get if you want to leave, but I'm not going anywhere until I find out what happened to them.
I never said I was leaving.
You son of a bitch.
To the fly, 'tis the prettiest little parlor that ever you did spy. The way into my parlor is up a winding stair, and I have many curious little things to show you.
Never come down again.
I'm sure you must be weary, dear, with soaring up so high. Will you rest upon my little head? Said the spider to the fly. There are pretty curtains drawn around. The sheets are fine and thin, and if you like to rest a while, I'll snugly tuck you in. Oh, no, no, said the fly, for I've often heard it said, they never, never wake again.
You sleep upon your bed.
Cyrus.
Emma? Emma, is that you?
Emma, what the hell are you doing? Emma?
What just happened? Actually believe any of this stuff, do you?
I don't know. It might have something to do with what happened to my family.
Grab either side.
You okay?
I evoke thee, O God of Osiris, in the virtue of the most holy sacrament, Jesus Christ, who, for our redemption, was crucified, suffered death, was buried, and rose on the third day by the power of the Spirit of the God Osiris. We pray to thee, O Lords.
Amen.
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 I, Benjamin, share the gift of the afterlife with Brian.
Elizabeth, share the gifts of the afterlife.
I, Faith, share the gift of the afterlife.
What is it?
Do you hear that?
Mr. Judson.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
I called the hotel this morning. They said you never even checked in.
You know, I lost track of time, and I decided to crash here.
Well, it would have been helpful if you called to let me know.
You're right. I'm sorry. I should have.
All right, well, we're both here now. What do you say we get down to business?
Sure. Come on in.
Hold on.
Is well above market value. So if I were you, I wouldn't even bother negotiating. Just sign it, be done with this dump.
Yeah, I mean, I'm sure it's great.
Trust me, if you're holding out for something better to come along, it will not be happening in this economy.
I trust you. It's just, I'm not really sure.
I know. Real estate can seem like a daunting task sometimes. But that's why I'm here, walk you through it.
What if I didn't want to sell the house?
Excuse me?
I sort of feel obligated to keep it. It's my family's home.
Johnny, you didn't even know that.
Yeah, I know that.
Listen, kid. I took on this case under the agreement that I receive a percentage of the sale.
I'm sorry, Mr. Judson.
Then maybe you should rethink making such a detrimental decision. It's the last thing that I need.
Who is that? He's been harassing me.
That's David Mackey. Mac, guess you could say he's your half-brother.
What?
Benjamin wasn't exactly the most faithful husband. But don't worry, he doesn't have any claim to the estate. I'll handle it.
My brother?
Hey, David!
Yeah, this really isn't the time or the
place. I just want to talk to him.
Yeah, what I understand, you already talked to him yesterday.
I want to talk to Brian.
Yeah, he goes by Johnny now.
I want to talk to Brian. Where'd Daniel put him?
We can arrange a time, a place that's fine.
Give me the baby, Daniel.
Excuse me?
Oh, there's one more.
David, you really need to get going now.
Hey. What's going on?
I'm not sure.
Give me the baby, Daniel!
Oh, shit!
Oh, my God.
David!
It has to be finished.
One more.
We gotta call the cops.
You can't.
We have to.
No, Johnny, you can't.
Judson had a cell phone. I'm gonna go get it.
He was right there.
Come on, Johnny. Let's go inside.
What are you doing back?
What the hell did you do with the bodies out there?
I didn't touch the bodies.
What's going on?
Look, I've been investigating this case since even after they forced me into retirement.
So you know what happened?
Yeah, I was there. Your father was convinced that there was a code in the Bible that somehow linked the resurrection of Jesus to the Egyptian god Osiris, that he used it to rise from the dead.
I found his Bible last night.
Well, there was only one problem. They never completed the ritual. And so your family is now trapped in limbo.
Wait. Why?
They want the last survivor.
Look, trust me. Until they have finished what they started, their souls can't move on. Your father told me there was one more.
One more? That's what Max said.
Right now, they're out looking for hosts. Now, the living, they're very hard to control. But the dead, free for the taking.
What can I do to help?
Years ago, your brother Daniel saved your life by hiding you in the basement. And maybe if we contact him, he'll do it again.
Something's happening.
What?
Oh.
We better hurry. Need the quality of the sitters. Something that belongs to us. And the purpose.
And what?
The dead sometimes send a marker to connect them to the living. A gift. Did you receive anything like that? Well, we couldn't have picked a better location.
Do we hold hands now or something?
No. We just wait. Daniel, are you there? Daniel?
Daniel, it's me, Brian.
Daniel, we want to help you.
He's here.
Daniel, show us how we can help you. Daniel, please.
What does that mean?
I've heard about it before. In school, it's supposed to go in the heart during a crucifixion to end suffering. It was withheld from Jesus.
The Conroys only had 4 nails each. There's one more. It wasn't you, it was the nail.
Then why are they still after me?
Benjamin Conroy pledged the entire family to Osiris. He has to fulfill his promise. But before he died, he didn't want to finish the ritual. He wanted to end it. Oh, God.
worked.
Don't open it.
It's my mother.
Come on.
Hey, no, no, it's okay. What are you doing here?
I needed to see my baby.
I'm so sorry for everything.
It's
I shouldn't have come.
It's okay. Everything's gotta be fine. Will you walk into my parlor? Said the spider to the fly.
You're not my mother.
Yes, she is.
I am, Brian. I am your mother. It's time you joined your real family.
No.
Don't you want to live forever, Brian?
Faith, we can all get what we want here tonight.
All I want is my baby back.
Share the gift of the afterlife with me.
You're not part of the final step. Scared, Brian. We're all meant to be together. I just want to hold my baby boy again. Come with us.
Everything's gonna be okay.
Emma!
please don't do this! Stop! Stop!
Stop! Please, 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 please let me go! Please! You don't have to do this! You don't have to do this! It's not me! It's not me! It's the fifth nail! Daniel understands! Please! You're making a mistake! Stop! Stop! Mom, let me go! You don't need to do this! You're making a mistake! Please, stop! Benjamin! Dad, please just stop! I can help you, you don't have to do this! Just let me go! Please! Please, just stop! Please! You don't have to do this! Mom, just let me go, I can help you! Emma! Help, please, somebody! Just stop. You don't have to do this. I can save you. Please. I know how to help you. I know what to do to save you. Just let me go. You don't have to do this. It's the fifth nail. It's not me. Please. Please, please. No, no. Just stop. Oh, God. Stop. Please, 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 please. No, Mom. Please, Mom. Please. Stop. No, 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 please, Mom, let me go, let him go. Oh, God! Ah! Ah! No! God! Ah!
You're okay.
She saved my life.
I'm sorry. Emma's gone.
Emma's gone. Daniel.
Hey, boy.
Thank you.
So how about you tell me what happened here?
I wouldn't even know where to start.
Sheriff Deppert was a good friend of mine. And after his retirement, I kept him in the loop on the Conroy case. He shared the evidence, and he gave me his theories. I'll tell you, I thought he'd completely lost it.
He wasn't crazy.
Well, why don't we get you to the hospital, and then we can iron out this story before you talk to anybody else.
Thank you.
I tell you, kid, I just want to get you on your way home, that's all.
I am home.